Hi, this is Annie Dance. I'm an investigative independent journalist working to shine a light on police and policy issues in Western North Carolina and beyond. Today, Wednesday, June 12, 2024, let's see what lawmakers have to say with Today at the NCGA. As a reminder, they do not archive their live streams, which is problematic on many, many levels.
Election under those new county commission districts yet, or is this year going to be the first?
Candidates one? Have filed underneath for the new districts that's coming in. The first election will be in November, as we just passed it, and I guess it was March that was coming in February.
And I'm going to ask for another follow up. And does this change?
I guess the answer is the only change that applies to this election is typically when they elect school board members in Watauga County, the top two vote getters get a 4-year term and the third place vote getter got a 2-year term. What we have changed is so that the third place, we don't know who it is, but the third place person will actually get a 4-year term so that it evens it up. And then in 2026, we'll elect the two open districts will be elected and it will line it up so that in 4 years, everyone will have run in a particular district and be serving from that kind of point on. The intent, both when we did the county commissioners and this, is that no member's term would be extended beyond what they were elected to, nor would any member's term be cut short of what they were elected to. So that's why the staggered term, and the easiest way to do that was just take the third seat and have it fall in for a 4-year term.
Follow up, Mr. Chair.
Follow up.
So for a 2-year period, there will be three Board of Education members who represent districts and two who are still at large. Is that right?
They will reside in those districts. They do not. So what will happen is in 2 years, we'll elect the first two that are vacant seats right now. None of those candidates would have served in and will be elected to districts. And when then those three terms end, they will be elected to districts. So this election is proceeding. There's no change to this election. They're all elected countywide, except for the fact that whoever comes in third will now serve a 4-year term.
Thank you. And one final comment, if I may.
Yep, sure.
Thank you. This is very similar to what we did with the Buncombe County School Board districts last year. And the sole purpose of that, and it appears, as you just said, the purpose of this is to, I'm just going to be direct about it, is to try to ensure that there is Republican representation on these boards of commissions, and in this case, the Board of Education, in counties that are primarily blue. And while I am all about sharing representation, and I think that's a great idea, I just want to point out that we do not do the same thing in counties that are red. So what we have done in counties that are red for school board elections is make them partisan, which helps ensure that everybody who is elected to school board will be a Republican because the county is majority Republican. In places like Buncombe and Watauga, they have not been made partisan, which I agree with, but that has been the choice that has been made because, of course, in those counties, putting a D by someone's name will increase their chances of being elected. So I appreciate, again, the desire to have multiple diverse voices on these governing bodies. I actually think that's a good thing. What I object to with regard to what we did in Buncombe County and this bill and the bills that are making the boards of education partisan is that it is all driven to ensure representation by one party and not the other. And if we treated it differently, if, for instance, in Henderson County, which elects their school board by district and partisan, or no, I'm sorry. They have partisan elections, but not districted elections, because if they had districted elections along with partisan elections, they might actually elect one Democrat. But we don't do that in red counties. because we are not, there is not a principle here of actually ensuring diverse voices. There is a principle of ensuring Republican voices, and in some cases, only Republican voices in these governing bodies. And again, I just have to register an objection to that objective.
Senator Heiss.
Thank you, and I think it's important to note why this is a local bill. First, I would challenge the representation that somehow Watauga County is a blue county. I would refer you to any of the presidential elections in the past and to see which way that county has gone. That's coming in. Secondly, the elections are already partisan. That's coming in. This doesn't change that. The county commissioner elections have always been partisan, even when elected by countywide vote. They still run in primaries. They still put an R&D next to their name. That's coming in. So none of those factors are actually here. I will tell you that Watauga County is unique in the concept that in a county of 55,000 people, you have a university on a very small footprint of temporary four-year residents that represent 20,000 individuals in that county. And a lot of the complaints about the influence that those temporary residents have in these kind of elections comes as much from Democrats that I've talked to in the county as it does Republicans, depending on the issue. Matter of fact, the entire history of students voting in elections began when the Democrats attempted to keep the students from voting for alcohol elections in Watauga County and trying to keep Boone dry. That's coming in, and that really started some of the federal court cases that challenged it. So this was a Democrat issue 20 years ago, trying to make sure that issue was not there. And so there's a long history there in dealing with that influence, and the school's grown from 10,000 to 20,000 in that time period.
Senator Marcus.
I had a question about, as I understand your bill, it's changing what is now 6 members, all elected countywide to the Board of Education, to now have no countywide representation. Seems to me that's an oversight, to not have even one person elected whose job it is to look out for the entire county. Is there some, and that's a big change from, you know, everybody's countywide to nobody is. Have you heard from local folks about that aspect of this bill and what they think that might do to the?
Yeah, and looking at the county commissioner we're looking at the school board specifically, as this bill does. The 5 members were elected countywide. At the conclusion of this, they will all represent districts of the county. You really have a lot of individuals who are concerned that no one represents their school. That everyone in here could be from the small area of Boone, and no one would represent any of their other schools. It is important to note, as required in redistricting principles, that these 5 districts cover the entirety of the county. There is no part of the county that is now not represented on the school board, and the entirety is represented by the entire school board.
Oh, it looks like the legislature. Senator Perry.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'd move for a favorable report.
Got it. Any other questions from the committee? Any other urban areas of the state want to comment on Watauga County? Seeing none, all in favor of Senator Perry's motion to approve Senate Bill 9.
Don't we normally ask if there's anybody from the public that wants to speak?
We can. Anybody from the public that wants to speak on Senator Heiss's local Watauga County bill? I see one commissioner, I think, is from Ashe County back there. But
some from Ashe, maybe. So no one signed up.
Okay. All right, so seeing none, the motion from Senator Perry is that we will approve Senate Bill 912 as amended, rolled into a new PCS, unfavorable as to the original bill with a referral to rules. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, no. Ayes have it. Bill passes. Congratulations, Senator Heiss. We are adjourned.
Very, very interesting. So keep a close eye on this. I think a lot of a lot of these local bills get ignored in the legacy media. So I do hope that was informative for you. I was waiting for actually the House committee meeting to begin, but it still hadn't begun. So I decided to watch this meeting. The Senate Bill 912, Election Changes for Watauga Board of Education and County BDS. Let me see if I can open the bill here to give you some more details on that. It was filed just 2 days ago on the 10th. Right now, the sponsor is only Senator Hayes. Of course, he covers many Western North Carolina counties, including Watauga. And that was some interesting history. So I don't typically cover the Boone area. However, when you have when a senator's has overlapping counties, it's really interesting to see the dynamics, because now there's precedent. Of course, it hasn't been voted on by the entire Senate yet. It is not law yet. Let me make that absolutely clear. However, I keep a close eye on these issues, because what happens in one county, of course, could become law in other counties. So the bill is titled An Act to Align the Districts of the Watauga County Board of Education with the Districts of the Watauga County Board of Commissioners to establish 4-year terms for all members of the Watauga Board of Education, and to prohibit the Watauga County Board of Commissioners from changing its method of election or redrawing its county commissioner districts until after the return of the next federal decennial census. Very, very interesting. Please subscribe and support my work with a paid subscription. I greatly appreciate it. See you next time.